السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. توكلت على الحي الذي لا يموت وتحسنت بذي العزة والجلال والجمال والجبروت واستعنت بذي القدرة والكبرياء والملكوت ثم الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبي القاسم محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه المنتجبين. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون ومن أظلم ممن منع مساجد الله أن يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها إن المساجد هي مؤسسات توحيدية. إن المساجد هي مؤسسات توحيدية وبيوت إلهية. يقول سبحانه وتعالى أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه ويقول تعالى وأن المساجد لله فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا وأقيموا وجوهكم عند كل مسجد وقوله تعالى يا بني آدم خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد إن المسجد ليس فقط للصلاة والدعاء كان المسجد في عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله دارا للعلم والمعرفة ومركزا للتحرك والتعاون ومنارا للهداية والإصلاح ومستشفى لعلاج الأمراض الأخلاقية والاجتماعية ومحلا للوعظ والإرشاد واتجاها للقاء بين المؤمنين ومدرسة للرحمة والمودة والأخوة والسلام وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله إن من مشى إلى مسجد من مساجد الله فله بكل خطوة خطاها حتى يرجع إلى منزله 10 حسنات ومحي عنه 10 سيئات ورفع له 10 درجات فعلى المؤمنين الإتيان بالمساجد المؤمنين والمؤمنات الإتيان بالمساجد فإنها بيوت الله ومن أتاها مطهرة تهره الله من ذنوبه وكتب من زواره ويقول الإمام الصادق عليه السلام ما يمنع أحدكم إذا دخل عليه غم من غموم الدنيا أن يتوضأ ثم يدخل المسجد فيركع 2 ركعتين يدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى فيهما ثم قال عليه السلام أما سمعت قوله تعالى واستعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. لا شك أن إقامة الصلوات والجمع والجماعات تعتبر إحدى بركة من بركات المساجد، ويجب على المسلمين والمسلمات إعادة النظر في أمر المساجد ودورها ورسالتها وأهميتها وحاجة الناس إليها. ليس المراد من المساجد هو مجرد البنايات، فعندما يقول سبحانه وتعالى إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله، أي الذين يعمرون مساجد الله بالذكر والدعاء والتلاوة، ويعمرونها بالعلم والعمل والأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر، وإعلاء كلمة الله وانتشار دين الله، الذين يعمرونها ببث روح الأخوة الإيمانية تحت راية إنما المؤمنون إخوة، وقوله تعالى إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. فالذين يرمون مساجد الله سواء كانوا من الإرهابيين الذين يفجرون المساجد في البلاد الإسلامية، أو الجنود الاحتلال في الأراضي المحتلة، أو الذين يعارضون بناء المساجد في الولايات المتحدة ويصدون عن سبيل الله، أو الذين يستخدمون الكثير من وسائل الانهدام والإفساد لانفصال الشباب من المساجد، نعم جميع هذه الجماعات يمارسون أسوأ أنواع الظلم والعدوان على رسالة بيوت الله، وهم الذين يخاطبونهم الله سبحانه وتعالى ومن أظلم ممن منع مساجد الله أن يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها، إلى قوله لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أكرمه بالنبوة وجعله رحمة للعالمين. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك وحافظ سرك ومبلغ رسالتك، وصل على وصيه وأخيه أمير المؤمنين وعلى الصديقة الطاهرة فاطمة سيدة نساء العالمين، وصل على سبته الرحمة الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة، وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف القائم المهدي حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائمة. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا سقما إلا شفيته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا رزقا إلا بسطته، ولا خوفا إلا أمنته، ولا سوءا إلا صرفته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضا ولا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
الحمد لله رمضان is approaching. whether it is Tuesday, April 13, which is sound like the majority are choosing that day as the first day of Ramadan, or whether Wednesday, April 14th, that either way you look at it, it's okay to fast on Tuesday 13, even for those who think that Wednesday is the first day, still they can fast on Tuesday based on the last day of Sha'ban. So let us start fasting on April 13, which is Tuesday, as the beginning of the holy month of Ramadan. Ramadan is Shahrullah, the month of Allah. And that is the time that we get back to the masajid. Ramadan, Shahrullah, and masjid, mosque, is Baytullah, the house of God. And the mu'min who participates and comes to the mosque is Zayfullah. So these three words, Shahrullah, Baytullah, Zayfullah. Month of God, house of God, guest of God. This is the approach of the holy month of Ramadan. And I like to dedicate this short sermon on the importance of the masajid. 28 times in the Quran, Allah mentions masjid or masajid. In one verse, the first verse, Surah Al-Isra, two masjids are mentioned by name and they are honored. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-harami ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Masjid al-Haram in Mecca, Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem, Bayt al-Maqdas or Bayt al-Muqaddas. It's pronounced both ways. These are two honored mosques mentioned by name in the Quran. There is one masjid that is dishonored in the Quran. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مَسْجِدًا ذِرَارًا وَكُفْرًا وَتَفْرِيقًا بَيْنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That was a masjid in Medina that 10-15 people, they made that masjid close to Masjid Quba, and they invited the Prophet to go and to pray and bless that mosque, and the Prophet promised to go to the mosque after coming back from the Ghazwa of Tabuk. But then this verse was revealed to the Holy Prophet that this masjid that they are promoting is a center of division, a center of hypocrisy, and they made this, as a matter of fact, as a platform to attack Masjid Quba and Masjid al-Nabi. So they had bad intention. So the Prophet changed his mind. He didn't participate, and he ordered that building be even demolished because it was used as a site for division and hypocrisy and making da'aya against the Islamic faith and the new movement. And that gave some, you know, the Mufassirin like Ibn Taymiyyah, they used this mosque. Although masjid Darar is an exceptional situation, but then they used that verse that any masjid and any community that they don't like it, they think it's okay to go and demolish that. And this is why the ISIS, they demolished so many of the masajid. They say, oh, these are like mahal al-kufr, mahal al-dhirar, and we have to demolish that. And that was really a division against the mosque that They became against every masjid that they don't like it. And this happened even not among the Muslims, even among the Christians. Like recently you heard about James Matthews, that he got 25 years in prison here, United States, because he burned 3 black mosques. You know, then they said white, black churches. They said white church and black church. And they make church a racist statement. Obviously, we are against racism. There is no racism in religion, whether it is Moses, Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon them, all of them were against racism and against violation of human rights. But this guy, because he didn't like the black church, he went and he burned those churches. And it's amazing that the investigators, when they were investigating an area, one of the churches, they found a debit card, and they realized that that debit card was used to buy some gas. And they realized that the guy who burned this site was the same guy that who used this card to get gas. And this way they found out and they arrested him. He was very sad and sorry in the court when they were dealing with this matter, but he acknowledged that it was a racist action. So except those exceptional situation, we know that the masjid is the house of God. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ The mosques are house of Allah. فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. So all of the houses of God must be protected, whether they are mosque or church, temple, synagogue. This is what the Quran says, that سَوَامِعْ وَبِيَعٌ وَسَلَوَاتٌ وَمَسَاجِدٌ يُذْكَرُ فِيهَا اسْمُ اللَّهِ. The places where Allah is honored, God is honored, should be protected. What is the main mission of the mosque? The Quran talks about the mission of mosque. لَمَسْجِدٌ أُسِّسَ عَلَى التَّقْوَى. The main point of the mission of a real mosque is a taqwa, piety. Through this piety, the Quran says, فِيهَ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَتَتَحَّرُوا وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّهَرِينَ. That the result of a mosque that is based on piety, then this place can raise pure people, mu'mineen and mu'minat, that they are pious and they are pure. How masjid, which is a place of taqwa and a place of tahara, how the masjid does this mission? It does it through remembrance of Allah. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال. When God's presence, God's glorification, and God's remembrance, this is the function of the mosque, that we remember Him, we honor Him, we glorify Him in the mosque. Now, some people may say, well, if it is just to pray and remember God, we can do our prayer in the mosque, in our house. What do we need to go to the mosque? فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Allah is everywhere. Why do we have to go to the mosque and pray? Mosque is not only a place for prayer, but it is also a place for people. So it is in أول بيت وضع للناس. للذي ببكة مباركة. Even the most significant mosque in Islam, Masjid al-Haram, that is a place for nas, for people. And in another verses, جعل الله الكعبة البيت الحرام قياما للناس. So it's not even Masjid al-Haram that is the greatest sanctuary in Islam. That's not only for Salat, but it is also a place qiyaman lil-nas, that people stand up, stand for truth, stand for justice, stand for education, stand for the mission of the messengers. So if you ask the Quran that what is the mission of a mosque, the Quran is asking us what is the mission of the Prophet to begin with? لِيَقُومَ النَّاسِ بِالْقِسْطِ. That the messengers came to establish justice. And this is what exactly the Quran says about the mosque. قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ وَأَقِيمُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. That even before doing the Salat and facing the mosque and facing the Qibla in the mosque, أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ. There is a connection between your prayer and قِيَامًا لِلنَّاسِ, standing for truth, standing for justice. For that reason, those who stand against mosque, those who stand against prayer, against people, against piety, against purity, against remembrance of God, against standing for truth and justice, people who stand against this mission, they are standing for the worst injustice in the world. This is why the verse said, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. أَظْلَم means the most oppressive, the most unjust person, unjust people are the ones who are standing against the mission of the mosque, and they ban people from going to the mosque and doing the job and mission of the mosque. Who are those forces? There are so many forces that they are أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ, the Islamophobia, the supremacists, the racists, the ISIS. There are so many different forces that they stand against the mission and the message of the mosque, Risalatu Buyut Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no reason to stand against a mosque if a mosque is serving. Look at in this simple, humble mosque, Islamic House of Wisdom, that's open, opens to everyone, and is welcoming everyone. Everybody is welcome in this sincere facility, whether Muslim, Shi'i, Sunni, Christians, Ahlul Kitab. Even if somebody doesn't even believe in God. A while ago, somebody came to me and he said, I don't believe in God, but I was talking with my family and my mom said, go to Sheikh Elahi and sit down and have a discussion with him. And I just came here to have a conversation with you about this, and we had a long, long conversation, hour, 2 hours, we're talking about this subject. So it is open to everyone. It's not just for prayer. Prayer is just one function of this facility. Just one of the things that it is, of course, important. Is عمود الدين إن قبلت قبل ما سواها وإن ردت رد ما سواها. But look at this food service. You remember we have this for last 15 years. It's became like more organized and bigger and better now when the pandemic started, but remember that we had this in Friday last 15 years. But when pandemic started, we increased the blood donations because we thought that there is more need in the hospitals for blood, so we opened the blood donations, and then we hosted the corona testing, and then we started this corona vaccination. We already started, and there is another one is coming this week. So there are so much of activities in addition to the mission of education, explaining what is really Islam is and what does Islam stand for. What is the meaning of jihad? Jihad is not terrorism. We always stood against extremism and always we condemn terrorism. And we explained that terrorism had nothing to do with the true traditions of Islam. Terrorism was the product of ignorance, the product of extremism, the product of imperialism, the product of evil. So the mission of faith, the mission of education, the mission of outreach, the mission of action, the mission of salat and spirituality, the mission of charity and helping the poor. And this is why Allah is telling us, Ya Bani Adam, khudu zinatakum inda kulli masjid. The masjid should be a place of zina, beauty. Make masjid beautiful. How you make masjid beautiful? What is zina? Khudu zinatakum. Take your zina to the masjid. Another verse explains the zina. Al-mal wal-banun zinatul hayat al-dunya. The zinatul hayat al-dunya. That means when Quran says take your zina to masjid, that means you take your children, then they learn, they get knowledge, they meet with people, they see people, they socialize with people, they get a healthy environment of making partnership and relationship, something that you cannot do it when you are just praying your house. And also in addition to your children, your charity. With your charity, you support the services of a facility like that. But charity is not only money. Some people have, God bless them, they support financially. But charity, when Quran says bring the zina of charity in the mosque, that means your beautiful smile is a zina for the masjid. When you dress right, when you take a ghusl al-jum'ah and a good shower and with cleanliness and tahara, you come to the house of Allah. So the beauty of your face, the beauty of your dress, the beauty of your cleanliness, the beauty of your friendship, the beauty of your love, the beauty of your unity, these are all zina that you bring to the masjid. So when it says, خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ, then is your manner, your morality, your spirit. Sometimes it is material, sometimes it is spiritual. Al-Imam al-Mujtaba alayhi salam, عندma kana yanahadu ila salati kana yartadi ahsana thawbin. Al-Imam al-Mujtaba, he is going to the salat and he dressed like he has a big, big meeting and very official. ولما سئل يا ابن رسول الله لماذا تلبس احسن ثيابك, you just want to pray, be casual and be relaxed and do your prayer, you don't have to dress that way. قال عليه السلام ان الله جميل ويحب الجمال فاتجمل لربي وهو يقول خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد. I'm just obeying the order from Allah that he said that I have to be that way. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, من أسرج في مسجد من مساجد الله سراجا لم تزل الملائكة وحملة العرش يستغفرون له ما دام في ذلك المسجد ذوء من السراج. So beautiful that when you bring some light to the masjid. So you can interpret nowadays, those days they have the candles, today you pay for the electricity, that way you bring light. Or doesn't have to be physical. The light of your ideas, the light of your love, the light of the life that you bring to the Bayt Allah. This light is the light that is included in this hadith that the Prophet said, لَمْ تَزَلْ الْمَلَائِكَ, as long as that light, whether physical or spiritual or moral or educational, as long as that light lasts, الْمَلَائِكَ وَحَمَلَةُ الْعَرْشِ, the angels of Allah and all those spiritual forces of this universe, that they are carrying the job of the life of this world, they continue their dua, their prayer, their istighfar, asking forgiveness for you, because you were the source of light for the house of God, and you became an instrument that, through that instrument, the masjid's mission was fulfilled. The mission of the masjid, taqwallah, taharatullah, the purity, remembrance of God, honoring and glorification of God, education of people, bringing unity and friendship, these are all guidance, all knowledge, all purity, all sincerity. These are related to the mission of the mosque. And when you bring light, when you bring talent, when you bring energy, when you bring support, as a matter of fact, you are part of this light. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. So we don't expect those who don't have faith and don't believe in this doctrine, in this philosophy of the mosque, we don't expect them to support, but we support our mosques. We support Buyut Allah, and we support the Yuf Allah, the guest of God in his house. So inshallah, this Sunday at 2:00, we have not dinner, because we missed dinner. It's the third time that we cannot have fundraising dinner. But inshallah, we are going to have a fundraising online through Facebook and YouTube. And for those of you who can stop by, that's fine. It's between 2 and 3 p.m. this Sunday. And those who would like to support the mission of House of Wisdom, a house that is welcoming everyone with smiling and with love, and tries its best to do its mission as perfectly as possible, inshallah you would come, or online you would support that. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat wa tabi' baynana wa baynahum bil khairat innaka mujibud da'wat innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim inna a'tainaka al kawthar fasalli li rabbika wanhar إن شانئك هو الأبتر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. وإلى الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر.
صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله وأن عليا ولي الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله استغفر الله ربي وأتوب إليه سووا صفوفكم واعتدلوا مع التباعد الاجتماعي إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يسبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض الملك القدوس العزيز الحكيم هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين وآخرين منهم لما يلحقوا بهم وهو العزيز الحكيم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين قل يا أيها الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة، وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا، حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده، سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله، سمع الله لمن حمده، الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده، رب صل على محمد وآل محمد، الله أكبر الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده، رب صل على محمد وآل محمد، الله أكبر. بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأقعد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده، سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله، الله أكبر. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. ربنا إننا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله، وتذل بها النفاق وأهله، وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك، وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده، رب صل على محمد وآل محمد، الله أكبر الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده، رب صل على محمد وآل محمد، إلهي مسكينك ببابك، فقيرك ببابك، يا محسن قد أتاك المسيء، فتجاوز عن قبيح ما عندي بجميل ما عندك يا أرحم الراحمين. الله أكبر. بسم الله وبالله والحمد لله، وخير الأسماء لله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الله أكبر الله أكبر
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وآله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد يا من أرجوه لكل خير ومن سقطه عند كل شر يا من يعطي الكثير بالقليل يا من يعطي من سأله يا من يعطي من لم يسأله ومن لم يعرف تحننا منه ورحمة أعطني بمسألتي إياك جميع خير الدنيا وجميع خير الآخرة واصرف عني بمسألتي إياك جميع شر الدنيا وجميع شر الآخرة فإنه غير منقوص ما أعطيت وزدني من فضلك يا كريم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا ذا المن والطول حرم شيبتي على النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على محمد وآل الطاهرين
تقبل الله إن شاء الله الحمد لله I heard that Hajj Abu Khuzur is doing much better the surgery was successful الحمد لله Hajj Kamal Gabbani we missed his salawat last week but الحمد لله He is okay now and he made it to prayer. After a long time I see Hajj Abu Sa'id, long time we missed him. Alhamdulillah he's back, he's traveling a lot. So tomorrow at 2 p.m. we have the youth. They have program for the kids who are in the Salat. Don't forget, tomorrow 2 p.m. at the House of Wisdom, some artwork. Preparation for Ramadan. This Wednesday, inshallah, we have another vaccination for COVID-19. If you haven't done it yet, make sure that you register your name and inshallah, Wednesday come for that vaccine. This Sunday, as I mentioned, between 2 and 3 p.m., we have this fundraising. And it's very important that we support Buyut Allah. Also, since this month, April, I heard by the Wayne County, they called April as the month of Arab American. So this April now is called for our community. This is a month of our community. To honor the contribution of Arab American, Muslim Americans in this area to services to the cities in, you know, contribution with your education in medical world, in muhandisin, in the schools, in business. So April is to honor our communities' contributions to the state and the country. And as a matter of fact, we have a book that recently was published, Building America.
And there are some immigrants' stories in this book. You can get it from Secretariat. As a matter of fact, they asked me also one chapter. I wrote how I came to United States, a few pages. If you want to get that book, that is with the Secretary. And saying that, I promised to mention a couple of mas'ala about the Jama'ah. So if you come for Salat al-Jama'ah, the best thing to come on time, right? From the beginning. So don't be late, that's the best. So it's a normal thing to do the prayer. You don't have to do Surah al-Hamd and Qul Hu Allah, Imam does the job. As a matter of fact, today I had a long chapter, but I was merciful to you. I said, you might be tired. I changed my mind to Qul Hu Allah Ahad. Otherwise, I said, before Ramadan starts, let me do another big chapter. So that was, maybe I save it for next week, I don't know. But at this time, at today, relaxed that we went with a short chapter. But sometimes if you are late, if you receive an imam already started the first rakat, okay, say Allahu Akbar and you go join the imam. If you see imam is in ruku', you say Allahu Akbar wa tarka'. Man adraka ruku' faqad adraka rak'ah. So you save something. Although you were late on the ruku', but if you joined, if you say ruku' and you know be in ruku' with the imam, then you save one rakat, you are okay. The rest of the prayer normally go. But if you were late, not in the first rakat, imam already in second rakat and you came, what do you do now? When you say Allahu Akbar, it's your first rakat, but it's the second rakat for the imam. Imam does the qunut, you do the qunut, no problem. Although you is your first rakat, you don't do it usually. But now since imam is doing the qunut, you say the qunut mutaba'atan lil imam, no problem. Then you go with the imam in the ruku', and then for the imam is the second rak'at. He is doing the tashahud, but for you is the first rak'at, right? What you do a tajafi, yani al-julus ghair mustaqar, like you sit down like this. So you do something like this, that it's not completely settled, but something yani bain al-qu'ud wal-qiyam. You stand. So imam is doing tashahud, no problem. You can say tashahud, you can be silent, but you can say the tashahud mutabatan lil imam. So imam stands up. Now this is the third rakat for the imam, but for you is second rakat, right? You do what you do. Imam does the tasbihat al-arba, subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. He says it three times. For you, second rakat, you supposed to do what? Alhamd wa surah. So you do alhamd wa surah. If imam was so fast that you feel that you may miss the ruku, so just do the surah al-fatiha, don't do qul huwa allah or any other surah, and join the imam in the ruku. Now, if imam is already he's fast and he's already in ruku, and you are in middle of surah al-fatiha, that you did not even finish the Fatiha. In this case, you have to finish the Fatiha. At least you have to finish the Fatiha. Now, Qul Huwa Allah Ahad, you missed it, no problem, but you cannot miss the Fatiha because that's a part of it. If you continue a Fatiha to Wala Dhalin, but Imam is already up and is going to the sujood, okay, you missed it. You know, the Qatar is, the train is gone and you missed it. You continue your Salat Farada. You do the Salat Farada. But if you could join the Imam, I mean you recite Surah Al-Fatiha very fast, and Imam is still in Ruku, you join him in the Ruku, okay, then you are in order again. So you go there. For Imam, after Sajdatan, for Imam is the third Rakat, right? But for you is the second Rakat. In this case, Imam is standing up, but you would do the tashahud. When you do your tashahud, you stand up and you say Tasbihat al-Arba'a. And if you could not say all three of them, you said one time and you are still in, you know, still you are with the Imam. And that happens on the fourth rakat. Then Imam is standing, finishing his prayer, right? For you are still in the third rakat, but Imam is what? In the fourth rakat. He is finishing the prayer. Your duty is that you have two options. Imam standing for tashahud, but you standing for your fourth rakat. You already are three rakat. In this case, you have two options. One option is that you just julus ghair mustaqar, you sit down in a way of between sitting and standing. You wait for Imam to do his tashahud. When he is starting saying the salam, you stand up. That is one option. The other option is that you stand up right away. So Imam standing, sitting down for the tashahud, you don't wait for the tashahud. You just stand up and you do the fourth rak'at, tasbihat al-arba'a, and you continue your salat farada. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, ashadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله وأن علي ولي الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل.
السلام عليكم. Friday at Islamic House of Wisdom is not only a day of prayer but also a day of community service. Friday food distribution at the Islamic House of Wisdom has been consistent for the last 15 years. Our food and household materials are sponsored part by federal assistance and local generous people, serving over 2,000 people in each distribution. Since the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, Islamic House of Wisdom has continued its community contributions through blood donations, PPE distribution, hosting of COVID-19 diagnostic testing, and recently, vaccination services. Whether it's for your family or other families in your neighborhood, please do not hesitate to stop by any Friday and be a part of this service. We would like to take this opportunity to say thank you to our supporters, volunteers, and staff. Together, we have been able to be a message of mercy during this trying and global testing time. To continue these services, we ask for your assistance, either through donating or volunteering your time toward empowering, uplifting, and strengthening our community and humanity. May God bless and protect you and your family always. The Islamic House of Wisdom is a mosque and a community center that serves in times of joy and happiness, but also in times of tragedy and loss. Funeral and memorial services at our mosque are designed to provide suffering families with a sense of maximum peace, privacy, and respect. Our facility includes a maghsal washing room for the departed, an auditorium accommodating up to 1,000 people, a prayer room for Salat al-Janazah, and reception hall for any dinner gatherings or refreshment services. We also have private rooms for grieving families to meet in comfort. The Islamic House of Wisdom's three parking lots provide enough space for smooth traffic and transit during funerals and memorials. All services can be personalized based on your request. Our imams and reciters are ready to provide the most honorable and memorable services. Yet families are also welcome to invite the reciters of their choosing. Grave sites in Islamic House of Wisdom section at the local Islamic cemetery are available for interested families as well. In understanding how painful an emotional loss of loved ones can be, the Islamic House of Wisdom's goal is to be a source of family love, healing, sympathy, and support. For more information, or to make arrangements for a funeral or memorial service, please call our office at 313-359-1221.
We pray that you continue this journey of freedom, journey of eternity, with comfort. سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر بحول الله وقوته أقوم وأبرد الله أكبر سبحان ربي العظيم وبحمده سبحان الله سبحان الله سبحان الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب صل على محمد وآل محمد الله أكبر الله أكبر سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده رب صل على محمد وآل محمد يا ولي العافية أسألك العافية عافية الدين والدنيا والآخرة يا أرحم الراحمين الله أكبر الحمد لله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم